Hey everyone, and welcome to another daily video from Shopify Dropshipping Lifestyle. My name is Ricky Hayes. Today's video, we're going into how to make custom conversions, why and what they're used for. Okay, let's get straight into it. Now, first thing I actually want to add before I got into this, and I just have to get it off my chest because it's pissing me right off, is I spent 15 minutes contemplating if I should make this video or not. Now, this may sound stupid, but at times I literally have mind blanks on what to give you all, okay? Believe it or not, I am a human. I may look like a robot, may look like a twat, but I do care, and my last few videos have been more informational-based videos, whereas this one I wanted to be at least something of actual tutorial, and I don't know why I've been sitting here for ages, and I went on YouTube to get other people's ideas and saw like how to make $1,000 in 6.5 milliseconds and all that fucking crap. And it really pissed me off for some reason. Really annoyed me. Anyway, let's get into this. So this custom conversions, okay, is so when you are making an ad, you have the pixel events, you know, purchase, view content, add to cart, initiate checkout, add payment info, leads, search, and I think some others I can't remember. But for us, you know, we mainly use those three, right? Purchase, view content, add to cart. You don't really even use the others. They're mostly useless. But anyway, they're there, right? And they're events for specific things, okay? But you can actually make your own, all right? Now, that leads to the immediate next question. Why would I make my own? Okay, so the idea is that making a custom conversion is meant to, what you're doing is you're making, it's basically like a filter. Get my stupid phone out of the way. It's basically a filter, and that filter is a part of your pixel is taken out to over here, and it's making like a mini pixel. Think of it like that. That's how I think of it. And it's storing all the data in there. So that mini pixel is getting super smart. All these orders coming in, all these orders coming in, and it's helping to supercharge that custom conversion. The idea is then that it's meant to help supercharge your ad set to get you more sales, okay? Now, there is an honest truth to this. This does not work 100% of the time. It comes down to testing it, all right? There's no other way other than say this, other than you just have to test this. So once you have a winning product, or a product that, let's say, getting 5-10 sales a day, and you want to start optimizing and then split testing maybe creatives, obviously you optimize and split test the various demographics. You can also optimize based off things like conversion window, and you can optimize based off this, okay? So what I suggest is once you are getting any sales, make a custom conversion. I only ever make one for a product, and that's you using the purchase event for the specific product. Now, let me tell you how you do this. First, I use an app called Trackify. Now, this app is awesome for many, many reasons. One, it actually helps manage multiple pixels. A number of my students and that all use it, and they love it. It's been very successful. It gives a lot of flexibility. It allows you to quickly... They don't have an affiliate link. I should be using it. Huh? I'm pretty good at this. But anyway, you can use tags to see the individual purchase, add to cart, and view content using a tag. You can also do much other stuff. And it's just aimed at being quicker and more concise, doing it better, okay? Now, I suggest using that so you get more pixel events. The more data you get, the better results technically you're going to get. Okay, that's not necessarily true. I'm not going to say that if you have $1 billion worth of data, then you're going to make $50 billion from that, okay? It's stupid to say that because Facebook's changed a lot. But if you don't have it, it's fine as well. If you don't have it, it's fine. I'm going to add that in. It's just a recommendation from me to you. Right, so let's make a custom conversion. There's a few ways you can make custom conversions, and it's entirely up to you. I don't think this pixel is going to have much. Yeah, it's not. So what you need to do is you choose your pixel. I love Shopify pixel, obviously no data, it's just my bogus one. And you choose URL, and it always has to be contained. Okay, very important that it's contained. Once you get traffic, it's gonna show view content purchase. You choose the purchase event there. Or it's here, it actually has it there too. That'll disappear if you choose it here. So I don't even know why they have that there. So that's why I don't normally add it, but for the sake of telling you, That's where it is. Once you have a purchase here, you choose purchase there. And then you put contains the URL add rule. Okay, so for some reason it doesn't have it. But usually what you're actually after is content underscore ID. Rather than URL, there'll be content underscore ID. And what that is that because it's integrated through the Shopify store, your content ID is your unique number on the end of your product on the back end of your Shopify store. Okay, so if you right now go into your Shopify store, go into any product, open it up, it'll have a unique URL, you know, whatever your thing is, .myshopify.com, and at the end it'll have the forward slash and then a number. That's the number you need, and you copy it in here, and it'll be some, you know, number not that long, but some number like that, right? And it'll be a number like that. Use content ID as the value, and then you use the contains, and you put that in, all right? So what you're telling Facebook now is that it knows your pixel, you're choosing purchase, and you're saying that it's the content ID which relates to the number, and you put the number in so it knows specifically what product. The reason I do that is so it's very specific. If you are using Trackify, admittedly, you can also use content type, and you can use RR underscore track underscore whatever your tag is, okay? You have to use Trackify to understand that. If you're not, that's what you do, okay? Either way, realistically works as long as you're doing contains. Very important that you do a contain. And then you give it a name, okay? So CC I use for custom conversion. Really doesn't matter, but that's just the template I use. I like to use, you know, VV, video view, CA, custom audience, LLA, lookalike audience, CC, custom conversion. Just simple little acronyms for me to identify what it is, okay? And then, you know, again, I love my dogs and I bring it up a lot, so I'm gonna be consistent in some regard. You put in CC and then that, and then you put in what value. So purchase, okay? I only use purchase, I've tried. Other ones, they're even more useless. Just use this one and test it, okay? Test it and see if it gets you better results. There's no harm in making it. Once you're starting to get sales, just make this. It'll only start pulling data in once you've made it, and then start getting the type of event that you're looking for, all right? It doesn't pull it from the pixel and prior. It only does it from then on, all right? That's very important to know, all right? The value, just leave that. It's irrelevant. And then you literally go create, right? What it's going to do, blah, 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 is it's going to crumble with that crap. You're going to see here that's no activity, low volume. It'll have pixel, and it'll say, when you get a sale, you'll know it's set up properly when you see it go from 0 to 1, okay? That's important. So just check that after a day, if you know, however long, if you've got a sale at product and you set this up, make sure, and then you know it's set up properly, okay? And it's integrating and it's all working. All right, now, next question is, when can I use this? If I've only got one, can I only use it then? No, you can use it straight away, all right? You can literally use it as soon as you get one and you know it's working, split test it. And I have admittedly, what it actually has helped do is you put it in your ad set and then it's consistently getting this data. And actually, if it works well, as it should, then it'll help you reduce your CPM. Reducing your CPM means greater click-through rate and lower CPC. All right, so that's why you try this. There is no guarantee it's gonna work. As many of you ask me many times, and I see, and it happens to myself, is that Facebook is very random currently, but we try and work within the confines of some form of framework to allow us to get tangible results, okay? It's very important. Now, that's pretty much the end of that. I hope that has been very helpful. If you are, if you did like today's video, hit the like button, the subscribe, and the notification bell so you're updated as soon as I upload a video, okay? I upload 2 to 3 a week. It just depends on how busy I am a week. Don't forget, there's my free group on Facebook, Shopify Dropshipping Lifestyle. If you want to join and get a cheat sheet at the same time, there's a link down below, completely free cheat sheet, okay? I've just recently updated it. People are absolutely loving it. It gives you so much value from beginners to advanced. It's very helpful, all right? As well as that, I do have, obviously, my other services, which are linked down below, being my gold class, my platinum mentoring program, as well as my coaching program. All right, so if you do need any help in those regards, there's links down below, all right? One of the things that I've been doing, I just want to add this on the end, is I've been reading a lot of books, and so I'm trying to I really love helping people. It's always been a passion of mine, and I'm trying to push myself to that next level. So yes, many of you may dislike the fact that I'm pushing these services and stuff, but it is helping people. I've, so many of my students are hitting goals beyond belief. Like just a few days ago, one just, I think, hit nearly 7K days just recently, and he's continually going up. Absolutely amazing. Others are doing the same. All right, so I highly recommend that you have a look at those, okay? There's so much value that I give everyone. Now, lastly, I do want to add, and I want to add, start this now rather than just throwing it out of nowhere and pissing people off, is I have decided to make a course, all right? Now, this covers a lot of thought that originally I didn't want to make one, but I am, simply because a lot of people ask me about a course, and as a part of what I'm learning, I think it's a fantastic way to actually help facilitate your learning, okay? This isn't going to mean that I'm going to be cutting shitloads of content from here. It'll just mean the course is far more specific, far more targeted, far more in depth than I already do now, because I'll be spending a lot more time on that, but I'm not releasing that for a long time. I have other things going on, but I wanted to add that in, okay? I don't mean to offend anyone. I'm not trying to be like, oh, money grab, money grab, money grab. Of course, you know, I make this and, you know, and I'm trying to utilize my skills to make other forms of income. That's the natural course of once you start to progress. All right, I think that's very important. So I wanted to throw that out there. If I've offended anyone, that's fine. But I wanted to at least tell you, be transparent. Okay, I'm gonna always be the same. This is who I am. All right, apparently I have autism, high functioning, and I find it hard to lie. So it's actually been really hard for me to not tell you about this, because it's been something I've been thinking about for a while, all right? So thank you everyone who always gives me support anyway, and I'm sure many of you will continue giving me support in the future anyway. I will be making more videos just like this and other ones to really help you all, okay? I really like to give value, and that's really important to me. I don't know where to go from here other than the fact that thank you very much for your time. You all have a lovely day. Take care. Goodbye.